Hi everyone, this is Kevin here, coming at you with some really exciting leaks from Metro by T-Mobile. So let's dive on in and talk about it. So Metro by T-Mobile has a new phone coming out called the Foxed Miro. Now my source for this information is from Magic Tech Review. He's a really awesome YouTuber, and I just finished watching his live stream about this device. Now, I certainly encourage you to watch his video on his channel, but I also wanted to give my thoughts and opinions about the device as well. Now, very little is known about the phone itself and even the company that is producing it. I did a Google search looking up Foxed, and I didn't really see anything at all, which makes me think that maybe this is a new sub-brand that's being created by a larger company. Or maybe I'm just really bad at doing research.
So apparently I am bad at doing research because I just found their website. Now the official name of the company is Fox Development Inc. And they're based in Plano, Texas. Now if you want to learn more about them, you can go to their website, which is Fox with two X's, development.com. And on their website, they have four phones currently listed. Now, I'm pretty positive that none of these four devices, especially the one on the far right, are the Fox Miro. So I think these devices are all completely different, and the Fox Miro is a completely new phone. But you can see they do have experience with creating budget smartphones. And another interesting thing that I found too is that on the About Us page, scrolling down here, they have pictures of T-Mobile. And what's funny about that is that they don't mention T-Mobile anywhere. They just show two pictures, with one being inside of the store and the other being the outside of a T-Mobile store. So I'd imagine they have some sort of alliance or working partnership with T-Mobile. Of course, Metro by T-Mobile is owned by T-Mobile. So this further solidifies the rumors that we're going to be seeing the Foxed Miro on Metro by T-Mobile. They also create other hardware such as Internet of Things devices and other mobile broadband solutions such as these different hotspots. So overall, it looks like a very interesting company, and I'm excited to learn more about them in the future.
But regardless, it looks like this device will be coming out very soon, because I went over to Amazon and eBay and typed in Foxed Miro, and there are a ton of different cases now available for that device. Now, for all of those different cases, of course, there's a picture of the case itself, but then there's also a rendering of the device in the case. So from this, you can kind of get a good idea of what the device is going to look like. Now, on the front, I saw a variety of different configurations on the different illustrations of cases, so I don't think this picture of the front of the device here necessarily reveals what it's going to look like exactly, but I did notice that the back of the device was consistent throughout all the different listings for the phone cases. So in all of these different renderings, there are two things that I noticed that were consistent with the design of the phone in all of them. The first thing is that we're getting a single camera on the back and a flash, and also kind of a unique and very wide speaker grill on the back side. Now, just because it has a massive speaker size-wise on the back doesn't necessarily mean that it's going to actually produce good audio. But it is possible that this device maybe will have its speaker quality be one of its core competencies that will make it unique when compared to other handsets being offered by Metro by T-Mobile. Other than that though, at the time of making this video, we don't know anything about any of the specifications that this device will feature. But I have a strong feeling that this is going to be a very entry-level device. One of Metro by T-Mobile's biggest competitors, Boost Mobile, recently launched the Wiko Ride. Now, Wiko is another new brand to the US market, and they've decided to launch their first device, which is called the Ride, as a very entry-level phone coming in at just $40. Now, I have a feeling that with the Foxed Miro, we're going to see the same strategy implemented by having kind of this extremely low-end device be the first Foxed device to be featured on a US carrier. And the reason for that is because the Foxed brand name is totally new to everybody and is completely unknown, so the brand itself doesn't really carry any weight. So I don't think anyone would necessarily want to risk spending a lot of money on a phone with a brand they've never heard of. So likely what Foxed is going to do is break into the US market with very low-end, inexpensive devices that nobody could really refuse to buy because of how inexpensive they are, and then as they build up more brand recognition, begin to move up the market and maybe launch a device in the $100 range and the $150 range and maybe even higher above $200. Now, if the specifications of the Wiko Ride give us any idea of what the specs are going to be of the Foxed Miro, then we're probably going to be getting 16 gigabytes of internal storage, 2 gigabytes of RAM, a 2500 milliamp hour removable battery, and Android 9 Pie as the operating system. Now, I think it's pretty much guaranteed that we're going to be getting Android 9 Pie with the Foxed Miro. I can't imagine that the device would feature Oreo as its operating system. So that's certainly good to see that it's going to have Pi. I also think it's highly unlikely that the device will feature a notch on the front. And for many of you, this might be very good news. As far as the possibility of it having 16 gigabytes of internal storage, I think that's highly likely as well. I really cannot imagine that they would offer 32 gigabytes of internal storage in a very low-end entry-level phone. So 16 gigabytes seems highly likely. And for as much as I dislike having phones with 2 gigabytes of RAM, because it's 2019 and that shouldn't really be a thing anymore, I'm pretty confident we're gonna see 2 gigabytes of RAM with the Foxed Miro. And I really have no clue what kind of processor it's gonna have. So don't even get me started with trying to speculate that. As far as the cameras go, I can't imagine this phone will have anything exciting with those. I'm guessing maybe a 5 megapixel front-facing camera and an 8 megapixel rear-facing camera. So again, this is gonna be a very low-end entry-level phone. Based on my predictions, maybe I'm completely wrong. We're gonna find out soon when this device is officially launched. But judging by the cases that are available on Amazon and eBay, they're extremely low-end cases, extremely probably bad cases. So if the phone really is an expensive device, I can't imagine we'd be seeing all these low-end cases. Now I'd like to address another thing, and that is, why are we seeing all these new brands getting into the budget arena? Now, some of these brands that come to mind include, of course, Wiko with the Wiko Ride. That brand was completely unknown, like literally a few months ago. Another one is Coolpad. Now, Coolpad's been around for a little while now, but they've never put out a mid-range device. And with the Coolpad Legacy, we're getting very decent specifications for a very affordable price tag. So this kind of indicates that Coolpad is going places and Coolpad is trying to expand its reach in the US market. And now, finally, with this one, Foxed, we're seeing the same thing, a new brand breaking into the prepaid carriers. And who knows, maybe we'll even see unlocked devices being offered by Fox. But here's the reason why we're seeing all of these new brands coming to the market. And that's because I don't think the prepaid carriers want to go all in on a single OEM anymore. You know, seeing what's been going on recently with Huawei especially, and even ZTE to an extent with some of the challenges that they've had, I don't think any of these prepaid carriers want to commit to having a decent chunk of their smartphone lineup being based around a single OEM. I think they want to diversify and have a bunch of devices from a bunch of different companies instead of having like 3 or 4 devices from a single company and then being at the mercy of that company. Now, you know that I'm a big fan of both Huawei and ZTE, so I'm really hoping those two companies will be able to really bounce back from some of their prior misfortunes. However, I'm really happy to see too that we have so many new smaller companies breaking into both the prepaid scene and the unlocked budget smartphone arena. So I want to know what you think. Are you excited for the Foxed Miro? Are you hoping that there will be even more devices offered by Foxed in the future? And are you happy to see that more and more little companies are starting to break into these prepaid carriers? Definitely let me know. I'd love to know your thoughts. And let me know if you'd like to hear more news videos like this coming up in the future. But this is Kevin Breeze here. Make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Also, check out the Kevin Breeze Tech Community on Facebook, which I recently created. Link will be in the video description. We're going to talk about news and rumors over there, and it'll just be a cool place for us all to hang out and talk about our favorite topic, which is budget smartphones. But again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.